He bailed because he was sick of hearing about my problems on the way to work.
Well, it was during your divorce.
And he's like, I've had enough. You're bringing me down.
What a joke with Papa and Fortune on Netflix is a joke radio.
Welcome back, everybody, to What a Joke with Papa and Fortune. I'm Tom Papa.
I'm Fortune Feimster.
And we're very excited because our good pals, Covino and Rich, are in the studio
well,
with us.
Well, good to see
Thanks
you.
Thanks for coming in.
Thank you, guys.
I feel like this is when you, like, lived next to a neighbor for a long time and you finally get inside their house. You're like, oh,
and they're
this
a
weird in
and
here.
And they're a hoarder.
That's the best feeling, though, getting a chance to be nosy to see what's doing inside. I love that.
Right. If you live in an apartment, let's say you live in, like, I don't know, 9F.
Yeah.
Anytime I'm on another floor, I'm like, I wonder what 10F does with the same space.
Can I say this, Tom? You know what I notice most of the time? Because I still live in an apartment. It's a whole, you know, other story. I peek in there and I see, and 9 times out of 10 people live like slobs, and it drives me crazy. It makes me feel better about my situation.
You're like, I got it together.
Yeah, but I'm like, these disgusting people everywhere. But I come in here and it's wonderful.
We have a pretty lovely studio.
It's beautiful.
Now look, I've been a fan of yours. I've been a guest of yours. I've called in from carpool, dropping off my kids to your show.
Thank you, man.
You've been on the air for 16 years. I did not know that.
16?
Together, yes, yeah.
Is that insane?
Wow.
Yeah, going on 16, yeah.
Well, no, you would assume we'd be more popular. So, no, I like to say 5 years. We've been on the air 5 years together.
We're still
building.
Right. True.
Now, let's just address the elephant in the room.
Hey, that's offensive.
Hey. First of all, they were both very excited to get Juicy Fruit gum, by the way.
Because you know why?
You guys.
Juicy Fruit is gonna move ya.
Are you gonna?
The taste is gonna move ya.
Yes.
Yeah, but are you gonna really eat this?
Of course.
I am. I'm gonna surf afterwards.
Actually, isn't that what you do? You surf.
Right. No. You meet friends.
Whatever.
You gotta do the steps. Take a sniff. Pull it out. The taste is gonna move you when you pop it in your mouth.
I like it. I rest my case.
You happen to find the two guys in the whole U.S.
Rob Zombie loved it too.
He did not.
Yes, he did.
He was just like, oh, gum.
And you know what? It's only gone from 25 cents to 35 cents in 30 years.
That's right. They're kind to us. They want us to keep enjoying our lives.
Back when they lived off it during the Depression.
I love Juicy Fruit.
Juicy Fruit, me too.
Big Red was my go-to, but Juicy Fruit is always
Yeah, but in about good. 2 minutes, your mouth is going to taste
Nothing lasts forever, Fortune. You know, some things are just good and short little things.
It's cut from the same cloth of, what was the other one? Fruit Stripe gum.
And grandparents
would have the blackjack licorice gum.
You're just naming more garbage gums.
My nana always had Trident. She always had a pack of Trident in her purse. One more question for you guys. This is between Fortune and I.
Yeah.
You guys carpool, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Do you live near each other?
Yeah, I live in Sherman Oaks. He lives in Encino. We're like 5 minutes from each other.
You guys don't get tired of each other?
Oh, no, we do.
We very much do.
But we've learned how to make it work because we not only do carpool in the morning.
Yeah.
We have a second job. We have like a split schedule. We carpool again. So it's like, see you later. And we have to pretend like we didn't just see each other a few hours before.
There are days. Fortunately, we do a half-hour TV show every night on ESPN2 in downtown L.A. Covino will drop me off at noon. He'll come back at 4:30. Be like,
so
hey, what's up, bro? I'm like, what's up? I don't know. I played with my daughter and took a shower and had Chipotle. What do you think I did? I saw you 4 hours ago.
We've learned to balance it. You know, our careers sort of depend on each other.
Yeah.
We're friends first, so that works too. And we're invested not only personally but professionally. Yeah. So
it's like a couple that stays together for the kids because they realize if they broke up, like they'd be way worse off.
Right. So should I be insulted that Fortune won't drive with me?
Yes.
I don't want, I mean, you guys are being more environmentally friendly, so
well, not
I appreciate
only
that.
At least my car, so I figure it's just saving the miles too.
Right.
You know, switch to cars every once in a while.
That's right. I like my alone time in the car.
I do get that. You know our producer Spot, Beardy Spot?
Yeah.
He left our carpool because we carpooled for years.
Oh, yeah.
He lives on the same street as Rich.
So we
would carpool.
He bailed?
Yeah. He bailed because he was sick of hearing about my problems on the way to work.
It was during your divorce. And he's like, I've had enough.
You're bringing me down. Honest to God, true story. So
he's like, if I have to hear about this divorce one more time.
He's like, I'm not a divorce attorney. I'm out.
It was bringing him down. He was sick of giving me advice that I wasn't listening to.
Yeah.
And he wants to get into his zone like you do.
Yeah.
Like, you know, play his music and get into his vibe.
Yeah. I also I'm a very busy lady. Mm-hmm. I take a lot of calls in my car. It's kind of like my mobile office.
6 a.m.?
You never know, East Coast. What's up, New York, baby? That's what I do in the car.
Yeah, no, I actually don't really want to carpool you, but I feel like we could get to that point.
I think it's very nice of you, Tom, to offer.
We're never going to get to that point.
Thank you.
Yeah, I do.
Thank you.
No.
You know, you're learning something. I'm willing to drive her.
Yeah.
I invite you guys in. I give people gum.
Yeah.
One of us is very giving.
Right.
And one of us.
I've seen that for years. I've known that about you.
I imagine Tom offers pastries. You know, it's just the kind of guy he is.
I give everyone here has gotten bread.
I brought coffee in once. Guys.
But I'm confused. What do you listen to on the way to work? Are you a Rob Zombie kind of guy? Are you demon speeding to the office?
No, it's got to be pretty chill.
He's right.
I'll go with some
jazz.
Dave Matthews, okay. Sometimes some jazz. A lot of Stern. I listen to Stern a lot.
Of course, yeah.
We flip between Stern and 60s on 6. I feel like that gets me in a morning 60s, flash Phelps.
70s on 7 is good, too.
Yeah, oldies,
70s, I like the Yacht Rock stuff, the late 70s, early Yacht Rock radio.
Right, Yacht Rock
what
radio.
I'm a fan of. Yeah, for sure. For morning, that's good stuff.
That's good.
But again, these are things you're going to have to agree on, and you're taking calls, so yeah, you're better off probably.
Guys, I'm a mogul.
I heard that about you.
You ever take Fortune, you ever take a call in your car, and someone's in the passenger seat, and you do the whole, like, you're pretending in your car alone, and the conversation gets a little weird, and you're like,
oh, how do I navigate this one? But here's why you guys are lucky to not do this, because we do carpool. Rich does his BS sort of phone calls, like with the LA, what's it called? Like the power
DPW?
Company.
Oh,
yeah. He'll be doing all that stuff while I'm in the car and I'm subjected to this boredom. You know what I mean? Like, now I got to hear about his bills and all his stupid stuff, his credit card debt.
But my Wi-Fi's slow.
Like, I hate doing that on my own.
On your own. You got to listen to his thing.
So that is the downside.
Dealing with insurance companies. I paid the copay. Why am I getting a $900 bill for a pediatrician visit?
And now I'm whispering, like, dude, tell him you're going to leave. You're going to leave the company. Press 2, bro. Come on.
Oh my God.
Yeah, so it does get aggravating.
Well, thank you guys so much for coming in.
Thank you for having us. Thank you. A pleasure.
Always good to see you guys.
Thank you for bringing a great vibe here to Sirius XM, man.
Well, this is good. Yeah. I think maybe we'll actually finish the elevators one day.
Yeah. and the gender neutral bathroom one day will be complete as well.
Right.
2 years in the making.
All right, guys.
Thanks, guys.